Greetings of the day students. At the earlier lectures of this subject called Integrated Marketing Communication and Brand Management, we have seen various, we have defined and we have seen the integrated marketing communication tools. We have seen that these IMC as the coordination and the integration of all marketing communication tools within a company. So it transforms into a seamless program which maximizes the impact of value proposition or on customers at minimum cost. So we have covered many theory, tactics and tools. We have seen in detail that how we can use those tools in planning and execution for our market communication. We have also talked about different objectives which might have while communicating with our customer. We should be tailoring our communication according to these objectives. In typical market communication campaign, we have some specific questions which help us while preparing for our marketing IMC campaign. In this lecture also, we will see how to evaluate that IMC campaign with the help of various questions or various goal setting. We will be seeing this in this lecture that there are various methods which we can use for evaluating those IMC campaigns. Now we got to ask ourselves some question like to whom do we address our communication? Who will be our target audiences? Who will be our prospect for the communication message? The next question which we should ask ourselves is, what is the objective of that communication message? Or what will be the objective, what will be the outcome you expect from that particular communication message? The next question which we should ask ourselves that, what are the specific points which has to be communicated with the prospect or the customer? Which are your strength points which you should highlight in your marketing IMC campaign? That you should be very specific of. Next question we should ask ourselves is, which vehicles should we use to convey our message? Here we are talking about various media and their classification. So which media will be suitable for our message execution or message conveying process to the customer? That we should think upon. Next question is, what is the budget we need to allocate for our campaign? What kind of budget do we need? How we are going to allocate our resources for your campaign? That should be very specific. The last question we should ask ourselves is, how will we assess the impact of our communication campaign? Here we should expect some standard outcome which you expect from a particular IMC campaign. Also, we should think upon various methods or the procedure which will help you to assess the impact of your communication campaign. Now, before we start any marketing communication campaign, we need to establish our objectives, targets, standard. So the progress with respect to the target can be monitored during and after the campaign. So continued monitoring of performance against predetermined targets is essential in achieving the effective and efficient IMC, integrated marketing communication. For example, if an objective is to increase a brand awareness by 20% by the 31st of December in 2020, then we can examine after the date to see whether our campaign has been successful or not. So we can examine after the date to see whether the target has been met or not. So again, student, because the awareness is not observable in the normal course of business activities, we may use a survey as an appropriate assessment tool to conduct our research. The means we choose to evaluate the effectiveness of our communication is very critical. For example, evaluating our marketing communication activities with a before and after comparison of sales result might be unreliable because of the dynamic nature of the market. So the effectiveness of our communication campaign may be misjudged negatively if we ignore the fact that there is a major competitor who introduced a new product and he is supported with a significant sales promotion. Or suppose our price discount activity may appear extremely effective during an economic crisis, but due to increased price sensitivity in the of the consumer, consumer are not interested with your in your products. So additionally, regardless of how powerful and perceived our ad is, most of the people we are communicating with will not need with your product. They don't need your product which you are selling at that specific moment. So however, if suppose we can manage to establish a deep enough impression on them, they will remember our brand, and when they actually need something, they will make a purchase of your products. So we need to measure the effectiveness of our campaign against our primary communication objectives. So it is important to do it in a timely manner so that we can adjust and optimize our performances during the campaign. We measure our performance first within the platforms to assess whether we have achieved our target for that specific platform. For example, for an online campaign, did we achieve our objective in terms of click-through ads or the conversion rate? That can be answered, right? Then we have to measure our performance across the platforms which we are using for an integrated view of your campaign. So depending on the objectives of our campaign which we choose, we do have a different key performance indicator, such as maybe there will be some campaigns which KPI will be customer loyalty or the brand awareness or the brand equity or customer engagement or advertisement likability or recall of advertisement, consumer attitudes, number of email subscription, blog comments, tweet retweets, likes, and so on. So the match between the objective and the chosen performance criteria is very important. Additionally, sometimes multiple analyses can be done for different performance indicator. Suppose in order to have a more complete picture, I would recommend working with the multiple metrics and measuring those metrics before and after the campaign to observe the direction and magnitude of change in due to your IMC campaign. We may also evaluate our communication more qualitatively. For example, if we may evaluate the message and the physical design of the communication piece. So we should focus on those aspects also, wherein assessment of physical design actually involves evaluation of cognitive and effective elements. Now, when we have seen these cognitive and effective elements in brand communication introduction, we have seen there will be three connects with your product. So these elements, if we employ in your IMC campaign, that will give you some results, and those results has to be communicate or to be reach will be helpful for evaluating your IMC campaigns. So executional frameworks and the advertising appeals will be used to communicate the message which you are going to reach to the customers. So message evaluation can be done at the stage of the development process, and it will be attempt to measure the quality and impact of advertisement or a promotion. Now, moving further with the lecture, we are going to see some methods of evaluation of your campaign effectiveness. The first one way to evaluate the message is the copy testing. So this technique is used to assess the consumer evaluation when the marketing piece is finished or in its final stages of the development, but prior to the production process. So it examines consumer reaction to the main message of the advertisement, as well as the format in which the message will be presented towards the audiences. So copy testing is one of the very commonly used technique which assess the consumer behavior towards your product or towards your message execution. Another message evaluation technique is advertising tracking. So in this technique, consumers are shown portion of a particular advertising or a few visuals from a TV ad without showing the brand name. So it measures the whether respondent recognize the advertisement or the brand. Or this technique allows us to measure likability or the added brand advertisement or the message recall which is there in every advertisement. Next, recent development in technology provide us some new tools to measure our communication material. For example, the third one we have is eye tracking tools. So eye tracking is basically it is a very powerful tool to objectively measure consumer attention and spontaneous responses for particular marketing messages. So it allows us to understand how the visual information of an ad is acquired by the customer or the consumer. So eye tracking technique allows us to obtain information on the visual attention by analyzing the movement of the consumer eyes. So we can examine how consumer eyes move, where they stop, and what catches their attention. Sorry. For example, it may show that an advertisement with a model 75% of the audiences look at the only model's face, but in an ad, only 12% maybe look at the brand name. So that will clearly gives an idea that advertisement is not that much effective if you are tracking the eye movement of the customer. So knowing how consumer will actually examine an advertisement help us to optimize the design of our ad. Eye tracking studies use a camera, video camera or the sensor to pick up light which is reflected from the eye to extract the information on eye's rotation, and it will judge how the gaze falls on particular stimulus. So this technique will also allow us to see the sequence of observation of messages by the consumer. Next method we have is cognitive neuroscience. So it is a brain measurement process that will track a brain activity. So it will allow us to observe how the brain is psychologically affected by the advertising and the marketing strategies. See, this technique unveils the subconscious biasness of a consumer which could not be figured out by the self-report studies. The next we have is, which is very famous, which is very popular nowadays, is neuromarketing. So neuromarketing is the application of neuroscientific methods to analyze and understand the human behavior in relation to the marketing information. So it helps us to understand which kind of products and which aspects of marketing offer or communication material are more preferable for the customers. So it also indicates when consumer merely focus on a logo or an attractive model in a commercial. It identifies the positive and negative emotion and the intensity of the emotion by amount of neurons firing. So that's it for the methods of evaluation of INC campaigns. To the contributory part, I would like to say something that we've seen that many tools are at our disposal at every stage of integrated marketing communication campaigns. But we need to make sure that these tools, the metrics we choose to assist our campaigns, are relevant to our predetermined objective and the characteristic of campaign. So when you get this, when you balance these two aspects, you will get a more efficient and integrated marketing communication campaign, which will ultimately help the organization for better execution of their messages. So thank you for this lecture. Until next lecture, stay tuned and please subscribe to the channel of GS College of Commerce Vardha, eLearning.